Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Srikant. I work in FOSSI team in IIT Bombay. This is the session about basic Linux commands, advanced Linux commands, and few simple demonstrations about Android operating system and Android ADT and SDK. Why is there so much buzz about Linux? Why everyone is talking about Linux nowadays? Why not any other operating system? It's open source. Very good. Anything else? Virus-free, more secure, and it can be ported to any hardware platform. Any means not any, means most of the hardware platforms which support operating system, Linux can be ported there. And what makes it Linux so special? Why not other operating systems? Why not we port proprietary operating systems such as Windows or Mac on different platforms? Because they are closed source. You don't have access to the source code so that you can modify and you can port to your own hardware. And Linux in turn provides you the flexibility to use your hardware as you wish. Means you can download the source, you can customize the Linux source code, and you can run it on your hardware. So there is a huge demand of Linux professionals in country and around the world. Why? Because most of the countries, they work on small scale devices, mobile phones, tablets, you name it. Linux is everywhere. Maybe it's there in that camera, it's there in the projector, it's there in my laptop, it's there in router, it's there in Wi-Fi. Everywhere Linux is there. Probably you don't know, because you don't see a console there, you don't see an output there, you don't have a screen to watch. That doesn't mean that Linux is not running behind. Webcam, most of the webcams, they have Linux kernel running in backend. So there is a huge demand of Linux professionals all over the world. So what does those professionals do? Do they watch movies or play songs and they get jobs? No. They work on terminal, they run program, they execute program, they write source code, they customize Linux kernel, they write Linux drivers, source code, they modify drivers, they add patches. So these are the core functionalities of one developer who is willing to work on Linux platform. As I said, beyond browsing files or watching movies, what else we can do in Linux platform? For that, let me give you an example. First of all, why we need a terminal? Why we need a Linux terminal? Let me specific about it. Because we have a nice file browser, see, so this is a file browser. I can browse my files and folders, etc., etc. Why we need a terminal to access all this? I can access all this through my terminal also. But why? Because I can easily access docs PDF, I can open docs PDF. If you want to write a source code, I can open a source code in some editor, I can edit it, I can compile it. Then what is so special about terminal? Okay, what is special about this file manager? This is known as file manager. I'm using Ubuntu desktop, and this is the LXDE version, light X environment. So yeah, my question is, what you can do with this file browser? I can list all the files in detailed list view. I can see the descriptions, I can see the size, I can see the modified date, etc., etc. So what? Means, suppose, okay, let me tell you the drawbacks of graphical window so that I can motivate you to use terminal. So before that, see, I will explain each and every command which I am typing now, but take it granted that these are the commands which are required in today's workshop. So this is a today folder. In Windows environment, you say folder. In Linux, we say directory. In Linux, every file, each file and each directory or any device, anything is treated as file. Clear? So when I say directory, internally Linux treated as file only. So ls command will list all the files in present working directory. So when I hit ls, it shows nothing. That means there are no files in this directory. Now what I will do, I will create some files. So with touch command, I can create empty files. I can create files using gedit also. Gedit file name, I can save it. That will also create file. I can open a VI editor or Emacs editor. By that also I can create a file. But that file will not contain a, it will contain some size, default size. But with touch command, whatever file you create, the size of that file is 0 bytes. So this is for just demonstration we are doing this. Otherwise, I would have opened this with one of my favorite editor. I will show you how to work with editors. So let me create some files. So touch one, say one.txt, touch, sorry, one.mp3, enter. Can I play this mp3 file? Of course not. So ls-l will show the size of this file. You can see they both are 0. And anyway, if size would have been 10 MB also, by touch command, if I create a .mp3 file, that doesn't mean that it contains mp3 decoded file system. Okay. So I have two files in my today directory. Now same I can view from here also. Because my file manager is dumb, so it recognized that .mp3 means there is a song to play. And if I click this, it will open the default media player. But that is not true. So what is my point is, there are two files I can easily copy, I can sort. I know there are only two files. I know their properties. One is 1.mp3, another is 1.txt. Okay. So with Control L, I can clear the screen, or I can type CLEAR. Okay. So CLEAR clears the screen. It doesn't mean that my files are gone. My files are still there. You can view them as ls1.mp3 and 2.1.txt. Now I will show you the use of terminal, how it is better than your file browser, graphical file browser. For that, let me create some 100 files, say 1 to 100. How this works, just pay attention now, I will explain. Say txt. Before that, let me remove those 1.mp3 and 2.mp3. When I type 1 and dot and hit tab, it gives me the options available with my command. So I see there are two options, that is mp3 and txt. What I can do, I can type individual mp3 and txt, that will remove both the files. Or what I can do is, I can do 1.*. Star means all the files possible with 1. Remove all of them. It worked. If I do ls, no files. Control L, I have cleared the screen. Now I want to do some computing thing. So I want files from, see, 1.200, say mp3. So what we expect this command will give output. Of course, it's too early to ask you to expect something. So it will create 100 files from 100 files as 1.mp3, 2.mp3 till 100.mp3. They all are useless, but just for demonstration purpose, I want to show you something. Now I will do what? Touch 1.200.txt. So this will create 100.txt files. Why I am doing this, I will explain you. So this is my file browser. Now you can see how many files are there, 200, 100 mp3 files and 100 txt files. Now I say I am a project manager, I give you a task, a simple task, that I want file number, I want all mp3 files, just copy all those mp3 files to my server. You have to write an app, suppose in Android only, I give you a task, that see, this is a very simple task. What you have to do, there is an application which creates some random amount of files. and each automatically generated file will have a proper syntax. It will not like that it will create abc.c then 123.txt. No, automatically generated files, they have a pattern. Okay, so as a developer, I gave you a task that write an Android app which should copy all the txt files only from some directory to somewhere else. What you can do? You can either go open the Android file browser or Linux file browser, same as, and you can copy each mp3 file or txt files manually, and you can, yeah, that's an intelligent answer. I can sort it, detail list view, and let me sort it by description, correct. Okay, so now we are, what I can do is I can press shift key and I can take up to, sorry, it started playing. Oh, it will play all 100. No, thank God. Anyway, so I can, what I can do is I can select all my 100 mp3 files, right click, copy, and I can paste it somewhere else. So let me change the view of this. So I can paste all my 100 files here. Let me paste it. Okay, so my job is done. Now you can ask me that, okay, this is so simple, I can copy 100 mp3 file by sorting them and I can easily copy them somewhere else. Why I need a terminal to do that same job? Now how you will do with terminal? You will copy star dot mp3, that will select all mp3 files, and I will give the path where to copy. So this will copy all my mp3 files to /home/Srikanth. This is my home directory which you have seen just now. So in Linux, when we say home, you can see the path /home/Srikanth. Okay, already the files are there. If I do like this, it won't ask me, it will just overwrite. We will see this later. This is danger actually, you don't want like this. It should prompt me that, see, you have already these files, you should, you should, what you want to do, you want to overwrite these files or not? It didn't ask. Okay, so I have all my mp3 files here. So what I will do is I will create few more files. Touch 1 to say 100 dot a2c dot txt. So what this command will create? This command will create how many files? 300 files. Okay, now I ask you to go to file browser. Where is my today? Yeah, now I ask you to copy all mp3 files. It's easy to do. What you will do? You will again go to detailed list view, you will sort it according to description, select it, sorry, it will start playing, select it, right click, copy. Okay, let's do it. Suppose I have these many files, suppose these are 100 files, I just copy them and I will paste back to my home destination. That is as easy as previous command. No, what I want is, I want all dot c dot txt files. I want files starting with any name, middle name should be c and last name should be txt. Now there is a problem. You see the problem? Because when you sort it, you can't sort it according to middle name. Can you? Probably not. I don't know how to. So now I want you to sort all the abcd, all the files which have middle name C. Clear? Try doing using the file browser. You can do, it will take some time. Suppose there are 300 files, what about if this 10,000 files? It's possible. In automated generated data, there are some thousands and thousands of files. You can't manually copy each of them. So let me press Ctrl L to clear. So can anyone help me with the command? what command should I type to list only files which have, yes, which have C in the middle? Star dot C dot. Again star, sorry, dot star. So, irrespective of the output format, after it may be MP3, it may be TXT, I don't know, I don't remember, I don't care also. So, what it will list? It will list all the files with middle name C. Do it using file browser? You can't. Now, what I can do? I use copy command and I will give the path of home directory and will copy everything to home directory. Before that, let me remove all the files from home directory slash home star dot mp3. Rm command is remove command. So, this will remove all the mp3 files from my home directory. Just to verify, so I don't have any mp3 files here. Now, what I will do is, I will copy, that is what my boss told me, to copy all the dot c files which have middle name dot c and copy them to some server. So, for time being it is Srikanth. So, with cd command cd dot dot, I am going to the previous directory. So, as you can see the path, this tilde means home. What is home? Slash home slash Srikanth is path for home, isn't it? So, tilde slash today, the directory is, if I make it icon view, you can see the directory is in home today. Okay. So, yeah. So, you can see I have copied all the files which have middle name C. Now, can you tell me why terminal is important? You can automate the jobs. Okay. See, this is only one simple example. No one in anywhere will ask you to copy dot C files into some directory. There are many, many complex jobs which require some amount of programming. So, in programming, you can't program the cursor to click on the file browser, open the file browser, go to that file, that file, that file. You can't program your cursor to click every file for you. Can you? If you can, then your job is solved. I don't know how to program like that. If you can, it's very good actually. But what I know is, I can write a simple shell script. What is shell script? We will see later. Simple shell script to copy all the files which I needed by me, copy in some directory or to send to a server or plot a graph from that file, whatever. So, I can automate the task. Clear? So, coming back to slides. So, to just show you the, just to motivate you people that terminals are not dumb terminals, they are not old VT100 type of terminals, I prepared these slides on terminal itself. Okay? So, whatever you see, this is on terminal. If I do Q, it just quits, and this is TPP, terminal PowerPoint kind of, I don't know what is the extension. So, what we will cover today, we will see some basic Linux commands, advanced commands, we will see user group and permission in Linux, Android, users, okay, I will come to that, comparison between Linux and Android, Android SDK, NDK, not Eclipse, because Eclipse will take lot of time. Only introduction, no demo in this, emulator of Android, demo. So, you already seen ls command, you already seen cd command, you have seen cp also, cp means copy. See, whatever there in square brackets, they are optional parameters. Anywhere in Linux environment, whatever you write in square brackets, they mean those are optional. You may or may not use them. Okay. So, ls by default prints files present in present working directory. What is present working directory? How do you know? PWD. So my present working directory is home Srikant. So by default, without any arguments, ls prints the output. Now I have few flags for it, arguments. Hyphen a, what is hyphen a will do? Very good. So ls hyphen a will show all the hidden files also. In Linux environment, Unix environment, any file name or directory name starting with dot is a hidden file or directory. Okay, let me clear it again. What is H? Excellent. H means human readable format. So suppose I do ls hyphen l, l means list, detailed list view. First, okay, ls hyphen l, it will list all the files. Let me remove the dot mp3 files. Oh, dot txt, I think. Yeah. So yeah, ls hyphen lh, suppose a d, hit tab to complete it. What is source? 13 m, means 13 megabytes. Suppose I don't use h, of course I get a value, but I am not smart enough to decode it. It will take some time. Okay, so to make it human readable, if it is in GB, the value here will be shown in G. If it is in KB, it will be shown in K. That is human readable. What does R means, capital R? Recursively. Anywhere in Linux environment, unless specified otherwise, R means show recursively, copy recursively, whatever. Recursively means go inside the directory, inside the directory, and copy everything, move everything like that. Okay. CD, you already know. What is CD? Change directory, change to some certain path. What is copy? CP, CP means copy. Hyphen I means, very good, hyphen I means interactive. So we have seen that previously when I did copy star.mp3 to home directory, it anonymously copied everything and removed my previous mp3 files. Do you want that? No. Maybe my previous mp3 files were more relevant than my present mp3 files. Who knows? So in that case, what I will do? So let me go to the directory. What is the directory? CD today. So I have many mp3 files here. So I want to copy *.c.* to say ./. What this will do? What is the previous directory here? Exactly, home directory. Instead of giving the complete path, I can either give ./ or I can give tilde. So bash will understand, bash means this terminal prompt, will understand that I am talking about the default home path. What is default home path? I am the user. Default home path for me is /home/Srikant. Now I want to use the flag. Now this command will not ask me anything if at all the files are there. Actually, I removed those files. Let me copy it again, copy back. So I can see ls tilde, it has all mp3 files. Something was wrong, sorry. So now I want to use copy hyphen I *.c.* to again tilde. Now it asks me. Override this. If I type yes, it will override. Otherwise, no. What else? P. What does P means? I don't know. See, if you find difficulty to remember anything in, yeah, any command, if you confuse that what flag to use, I don't understand the flag. You have any confusion regarding flag, there are three things you can do. First, that command hyphen hyphen help. So copy hyphen hyphen help will list all the help information. So I will look for P here. So P will be preserve permission. So it says preserve the specify attributes. What are attributes? We'll see later. So this is the one way to see. Man CP will give me almost same information, but it's a manual entry, so it will have more information about the copy command. Or I can do info also, probably info CP. See, it's not mandatory that info and man will be available for all the commands, but most of the Linux commands they will have man, at least man. Otherwise, help will be always there. So any command space hyphen hyphen help will print all the help information. So hyphen p will preserve the permission. We will see later when we come to permissions. Hyphen r will recursively copy. So what I will do is I will make a directory. Mkdir will create a directory. Say hello. Go to hello directory. Now create some random amount of files. 1.22.srikanth. So it will create 22.srikanth files. Now I will go to parent directory, that is home directory, and now I want to copy .srikanth files including my .today files. See, inside my dot, if you do today, there is inside today, there are 501 possibilities. I do not want to list all the possibilities. I have created a file folder, sorry, directory, which is hello. I want the content of today, which contains some 500 files, and content of hello also, that means recursively. So here comes the hyphen r. If I do copy today, dot means present working directory. So where I am? I am in tilde. Tilde means home. Whenever in Linux we say dot, we mean present working directory. If we say dot dot, that means previous directory. It says it's a directory. See, it didn't copy anything. Are you getting this? By default, it should at least copy the contents of today directory, but no. This is smart enough and it knows that, okay, probably he doesn't mean to copy a directory. So why should I copy entire directory? Probably the user want to copy some file only. So it will prompt a message that I am omitting the directory today. What you want to do? It's clear to me that I want to copy something else. So I will say hyphen r today. Okay, it already creates an empty directory name today in the same place. So let me remove okay. So I can either copy all the files inside today. Today hello star, this means select all the files inside today only and copy them to home directory. This will copy. If I want to copy all the directories from today and hello which is inside the today directory to my home, I have to make a recursively hyphen r. But can anyone tell me why it's not copying? Because in home directory, the today directory already exists. That's why it doesn't copy. Okay. Move. So what is the difference between copy and move? Move will remove the source content after copying. Okay. Unless copy finishes, move doesn't remove the source content. So you can similarly copy. Control C will cancel the command and give back me the prompt. I can move today to say documents. So all the content of today will go inside my document folder. There is a flag in move which is known as hyphen I. There are many flags. See, if you see the slides, it says with frequently used flags. The other options are given in man entry or help entry. You can just type command space hyphen hyphen help, you will get entire detailed view. If I give hyphen I now, it will ask me, okay, it says no such directory. Okay, I already moved it. Sorry, I already moved it to documents, so there is no such directory to move. So actually my all my files and whatever I am doing now are there in today directory. So I want to get it back all. So how to get it back? Go to documents today and move it back to home, present working directory. Just wake him up. Okay, next comes the apropos command. How many of you used this command apropos? So this apropos will search for a command. Suppose you forgot which command will list all the files. Of course, I don't think in your lifespan you will ever forget ls will list all the files, but suppose you forgot which command will list all the files, what you can do is you can type apropos and I can write which command prints all files. But this is stupid to write, because anyway it's computer, it doesn't mean that I should write like this. So I will write list files. So it shows me all the possible commands which can copy content from, sorry, which can show the files ls. So somewhere here our ls will be there. Very smart, huh? See, it's not there. So once in a time, once in a while, apropos also fails. So I think you should type just list. Let's see. It's there. Oh, list directory contents. If I have typed directory, it would have given me this entry. But anyway, you have to, it's like Google, you have to optimize your keywords so as to target your search. So make directory already seen. What does hyphen p do in make directory is important, that's why I included hyphen p. What? Permissions. No, it will not preserve permission. Suppose I have I have today directory. Inside today I have hello. I want there should be a directory name as Srikant, and there should be a directory name as awesome, and there should be a directory name as, so the entire path doesn't exist. I want this world directory inside awesome, inside Srikant, inside hello. Hello exists, isn't it? So if I make directory, it's a I can't. If I do hyphen p, what it will do? It will create the parents. So parent directory for world is awesome, for awesome of course Srikant, and Srikant has a parent directory hello. So now if you want to see today hello Srikant, it exists. That's what I want to show you. This exists. RM command. Let's move fast little bit. What's the time now? It's almost 3. Okay. So CD today. So I have so many files. RM star dot txt will remove all dot txt files irrespective of dot dot txt. Okay, it will not, this star means any dot, anything before dot txt. and I want to remove star dot mp3 also. Done. So it contains hello, inside hello Srikanth, awesome, etc, etc. Let me create one file here to just demo you, 1.txt. So it contains two files now, one is file and is a directory. If I rm 1.txt, it will remove 1.txt, that's for sure. So if I do rm hello, will it remove? Why? Because this command will confuse. This rm means some files, but this directory, of course directory is also file, but this directory contains so many files. Probably this directory is empty also, even though it is not intelligent enough to decide that, okay, directory is empty, let me delete it. No. What it will do? It will see, it's a directory, I won't remove it direct. You just give me the flag, check it, whether it's directory or not, then only I will delete. So if I do rm hello, I can't delete this. So let me see what is there inside rm. Just hit tab twice, you will get all dot Srikanth files and two directories. If I reduce the file size, there should be one directory, no? Somewhere it will be there, no problem. So yeah, rm hello doesn't work. Rm hyphen r recursively remove hello works. So I don't have hello directory, I have only one file, 1.txt. Why I have spent so much time in these simple commands? Because these are the building blocks of any Linux based environment. If you program for Android tomorrow, if you program for iOS, whatever, I don't think iOS anyway you are going to program, whatever, if you program for Android or some desktop environment anywhere, back end of any graphical interface also are commands only. Even if I show you this file browser, probably in the back end, in the source code, when I hit desktop, what it does? LS desktop, and it shows all the files like this. It doesn't do something magical behind this, because these are also written by we people only. So in back end we have written some command, it will read that command output, whatever files we got, it will show them as a graphical output with directories as a separate image and files with some certain attributes. Is this clear? That's why in Linux command line is very, very important. You write any program in C, C++, Java, Perl, Python, whatever, Bash, anywhere, everywhere, you need commands to execute. And unless your concept is clear with command, you can't work. So okay, also it's better to know these commands, which top cat head help man tail free. So it completes as a sentence also, which top cat head help man tail free. Okay, let's see which cat helped. So which will tell you, suppose I used copy, no? Copy is a command, which copy? So it will tell me the path of the binary copy. So which space copy will show me the path of that binary. This is important sometimes. Suppose you have two versions of Python installed, okay? Python 2.6, Python 2.7. It might be with C also, you have GCC 4.4.4, you have GCC 4.5 also. So you don't know which GCC is executing by default, okay? What you will do? Which space GCC. So it will tell me which GCC is actually in the path. Top will give you a system monitor kind of output in terminal. We have a system monitor, graphical system monitor also. Just to show you that this can be done in terminal also, I am showing this. And this is important because while writing codes or etc, if you are in a terminal mode and you don't, in many systems you don't have GUI X installed. So you can easily view CPUs, it shows CPU uses, memory uses, etc, etc. I am not going in detail of this. So what is this? Next is cat. Cat will catenate the files, it will show the content of a file. You can even append also. I'm not going in detail. Just type man cat or search Google examples for no. In Google, you have to be very specific. If you type cat, you will get tons of YouTube videos. So head you also you have to very specific. What does head will do? Any idea? Very good. It will show the top 10 lines of a file. Suppose your file contains some thousands of lines, and you don't want to open. See, the 1000 line file, the size of the file will be around 2-3 MB. It will take some time to load. And suppose you have some 10,000 line files, and you have a program to copy the first line of each 10,000 files to some other directory or some other file. So, will you open all the files, 10,000 files in complete mode? No, you will open with the head command. Why? You want only 10 lines. In head, there is a parameter head space 1, it will open only the first line. So, you are not actually opening the file completely, you are just getting the first line information and your memory is free, your RAM is free. In memory constrained devices like your tablets and mobile phones, 2 MB file size is quite big. So, if you have a task similar to that, you can't do it by opening the entire file. Head will help you. So, let me put something in. Let me open. Why to use graphical? VI is an editor. Okay. So, vi1.txt I can open. I will make me in insert mode. By default, it is in command mode. If I press I or insert, it will go to editing mode. Just type something. So, I have 3 lines. Now, head 1.txt. Head 1.txt, I think hyphen n1. Yeah. You can see in man entry or hyphen hyphen help entry of head. So, by this command, I can easily print the first line of the file. Cat head is done, help already done, man is done. Tail of a file. Free will show you the memory. Memory means, are we talking about hard disk? What do you mean by memory by default in computing language? RAM. So, we are concerned about RAM. Hard disk is so cheap nowadays. Even RAM is cheap for desktop environment, not for mobile or tablet platforms. So, when I type free, it shows me the memory uses of memory. Total memory is like this, some 18897. Let us make it human readable. How to make it? So, I told you there are some exceptions. So, free hyphen m will print the memory in megabytes, hyphen g I think print in gigabytes. So, my scale is wrong, I should print it in megabytes. So, it shows me my RAM is 1845, used is, oh my god, I have to clear my RAM, 1445 is used. Okay. So, basic commands are over. Now, we come to some advanced commands. See, there are tens and thousands of advanced commands and basic commands. I have chosen only those which might be helping you in programming Android or programming any environment or day to day use. So, first command is tar. What is tar? Compress. It is a compression technique. It will compress the files or directories. So, tar is a very big utility. It has many flags. So, I have chosen some limited amount of flags so that our work should be done. So, you can see the examples right away. So, what I will do is, I will just copy these examples. So, hyphen c creates the file, hyphen f, I am telling that this is a file archive.tar foo.bar. Let us see. So, let me create touch 2. Or why touch? Touch will create an empty file, and when I tar an empty file, there is no use. So, 1.txt contains some lines, it is around 17 bytes. Okay. So, let me copy 1.txt to 2.txt, 3.txt. Sorry, I can't copy like that. So I have three files, 1.txt, 2.txt, 3.txt, each 17 bytes. So I want to tar this. So what is the command? Tar hyphen c will create a tar file. F means a file is coming right away. Tar hyphen c f. What should be your output file name? Means the tar file name. Let me give 123.tar. And which files you want to make a tar? 1.txt, 2.txt, and 3.txt. Okay. Enter. So I have a file 123.tar. So bash means this terminal detects that this is a tar file, so it changes its color. See, the normal files are plain black text and this is a red text. So let me see. Sorry. How to make it? It's actually in bytes only, so no need to change in human readable. So it's around 10240. So do you recommend to copy 17 bytes file into a tar file which creates a not 51, at least it should create a 51 bytes of file inside, means a tar file, but instead of that it has created, I can give hyphen h here also, 10k of file. More on this in spare time, because I haven't planned for these things, because they are very core topics, why it creates, because there are some inodes, they are minimum 512 bytes of size, etcetera, 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 whatever. But this is not suitable for copying small files, 2-3 files. If you have large files, you can compress them. And tar is not a compression utility. Tar.gz, tar.bz2, they are compression formats. .tar, what it will do? It will just collect all the files and put it in a container, like in a box. Are you getting? Suppose I have a source of 11 GB. Okay. To copy 11 GB file using your either graphical file browser or command line file browser, it will take lot of time. Why? You know, because those 11 GB of files, suppose it contains 11,000 files, each file while copying, it has some header or footer information, whatever, it sends it to the inode, means where you are copying, and it takes lot of time. Instead of that, if you put them all in a single tar file, so operating system detects as a single file and it skips many intermediate steps of each file's whatever overhead is there, it directly copies the single file. So it's faster and it's easy to manage also. So if I have some 10,000 of 1.txt, 2.mp3, it's better to create in a tar file and put it everything in there, or I can create a directory, I can put it there also. My next command is creating, sorry, it's a listing. Before that, I want to create. So if I put z, it will create a tar.gz. I have to give the extension here. So this is a compression. ls hyphen lh 123.tar.gz. It's 162 byte. Earlier it was 10k. You remember? If not, also I can show you. It's around 10k. So there's a compression format gz which is very very commonly used. There's another compression utility known as bz2, which is even higher compression algorithm. You can just give, I think, j and make it bz2. I think it should create. No, I have to see the help. There should be one option or flag to make it bz2. I am not spending time on that. So you can easily explore that. So what I am trying to say is, you can compress files using command line utility, which is very very important. Suppose you are a system admin, you have a server running somewhere in US or Canada, where there are many temporary files created by Apache or some log files, etc. daily, and you have to take backup daily from server to your home machine or your own server in IIT, wherever. What you will do? Do you copy each file? you will write a shell script which will execute in the server, probably in wherever, Canada suppose. It will tar the file and it will send the file, or you can use some rsync utility. There are many command line utility which will incrementally copy the file, etcetera, etcetera. So, tar is very important. So, tar hyphen tvf will show the content of files, same as this. If I go to today, if I click on this, it will show me the content. So, how do you see the content in command line? Tar hyphen tvf and 123 dot, it will show me the content of file, tar file. Is it so boring? Yeah, it's boring, I know, because these are command line utilities. See, if you want to excel in Linux or any programming language, because basically most of the programming language, they support Linux environment, they are open source, and someday you need to learn these things. So, it's better, why not to start today? Though it looks boring, but let me tell you, this will help you a lot. Zip, you all know, because I think most of you have used Microsoft's own operating system for your purpose. So, you can zip files like zip file name, what should be the output of the file, space file 1, file 2, like that. I do not want to show the demo for this, it is quite understandable. Similarly, you can unzip the files. Oh, we have not seen how to untar the files, sorry. So, I have tar.gz file tar hyphen x. This is the important flag. X means extract, C means create a tar, X means extract the tar. V verbose, F it is a file. So, tar hyphen xf whatever, my 123.tar.gz. So, I can see actually they were already present here. So, it is just over. There are flags to make it interactive. So, I can make a tar hyphen some xy flag which will ask me, this file already exists, do you want to replace? You have to find it in the man page or help menu. Huh. Grep is important. How many of you heard of grep? Oh, I am boring you people, I know, because I thought you people are not aware of Linux commands, but most of you do. Good, it is actually good. So, even though I will show you grep, type help or man to get list of options with this, and grep will, grep is very useful tool. It can grep inside the file. Grep means it will, it can search for that pattern inside a file also. It can search that pattern in a directory. If the pattern name matches in file name, it will show that, okay, suppose I type hello, grep hello in some directory. Suppose I do grep, see hello in some xyz path, say tilde slash downloads, and make it recursively. So, what it will do, it will search for this pattern inside the download directory. So, it says say inside english.cube.wordfrequency. Oh, I have this file, I did not even notice. So, there is a word hello. Okay. So, with I, you can ignore the case. So, if I make it lowercase also, it will ignore the case and it will print all the patterns with hello. Earlier, why it did not print? Because I did not give the hyphen I flag. So, it means if hello is present, then only you print. Now, it says these many hellos are there with different cases. So, definitely my hello is also there. So, it took all caps, it ignored cases, whatever. So, these many hellos are present in the file. You can see one of them will be file name, whatever, inside content of the file, one of is the file name. Okay. Can anyone has the answer for this? What are these numbers? I think it is the character number, means word count, location, count of that. If required for any programming purpose, then I will dig through this and I will find out, okay, what is that number. But for now, I don't need to find that number. You can anyway find it. See, there are tens and thousands of options in all the commands. It's very difficult to remember. So whatever important flags are there, I'm just covering those. You can easily find. Thanks for asking anyway. DF, what is DF? Man DF, disk space uses. So DF, so it will open my laptop before you and it says how many partitions I have. So it has these many partitions. These are not created by user, not important now. So DF hyphen H will make it human readable. So if it is in kilobyte, it shows in kilobytes. If it is in megabyte, it shows. There is another command, DU, disk usage. So what is the difference between LS hyphen LH and DU? It's very interesting actually. So in today I have 123.tar.gz. So LS hyphen LH 123.tar.gz. gives me how much? 162 bytes. So no need of human readable flag also. It gives me 162 byte. So with du command also I can find it. Du hyphen h 123.tar.gz. See the difference. It shows me how much? 4k. But actually what is the size of these files? They are 162. But due to the block size of my disk partition, whatever file system I am using ext4, maybe the minimum block size it detects is 4k. So disk uses, it will tell me that whatever disk I am using for these three files. In a way this is also very relevant. Probably I have a hard disk of 4kb and I am trying to copy four files which are of say 163 bytes only. But it will say hard disk full because my disk uses say 4kb. Probably not, because it will accommodate up to 4k of files. The minimum unit is 4k, it will accommodate up to 4k of files. So it shows that 4k is the disk block, minimum block. Okay, sh will summarize the output. So let us see the use of sh. So if I want du hyphen sh, it will summarize, I can give the path of directory today. It says 44k recursively. It will summarize everything, collect the information and tell 44k of memory disk uses, disk I am using for today. So there are few more advanced command. Have you heard of mount command? Probably yes, because you are very smart people. So mount will show all the mounted partitions. Okay, so when you connect a pen drive in your Linux machine, what it does, it first it creates a node in /dev/sdb or sdc. Okay, I told you that in Linux everything is treated as files only. So that node I need to mount somewhere. Mount means I need to, if I want to access the files present in that node, I have to provide a path for it, file system for it. So I can give the node of that and destination, it will mount there. And it happens automatically in most of the Linux distributions. So if I attach the pen drive, it will automatically mount it to /media/xyz. Okay, so it shows me the different mounted partition. To mount from command line, you need a root access for the system. What do you mean by root access? Root access means administrative privileges. Okay, so this is the example. I am not showing this example. There are many options you can easily explore. Okay, as I already told you, whatever commands I have sorted out, these all are important for Android administration, Android system properties, Android system administration kind of things. So setting environment is also very important. What is environment? I am getting this Srikant @Linux is somewhere set. otherwise I would have got something at the rate something. Okay, when I type ls, it knows where the ls is. How it knows? Because the environment is set. So where the ls is, how to know which ls? Bin ls. So how does it know it is in bin ls? Because there is a bash environment set for this. How to know where the environment, what is the environment? Just echo, echo means print, dollar, dollar is variable, path variable. So it will print, oh my god, I have so many paths. So it will print all the available paths for my bash environment. What does it mean? What is the significance of this? Tell me. Because already my paths are set. Why I need to give a custom paths for everything? Suppose, exactly, suppose you downloaded a package which contains some binaries and you do not want to put those binaries in your slash bin slash user bin, which are the default system locations where the binaries are available. Your application does not allow, you do not have sudo access support. Sudo means root access. You do not have a root access to see, to copy in, so slash means root partition, main partition of the Linux. It contains many directories like boot, cd-rom, dev, home, etcetera, etcetera. And among these directories, you have access to only home directory. Inside home, cd slash ls cd home, there is one user because this is my laptop. If you have multiple users, it will have a multiple directories here of each user having its own directory. Now, what I am going to make a point is, you do not have access to other directories like this directory bin, it contains binaries. You want to see ls slash bin, these are my binaries and here is my ls command. This is already set by distribution, Linux distribution, whatever distribution I am using. It's all these paths are already set, so I don't have to worry about. To copy a, my binary, suppose vi hello dot c, let me write one small hello program. So, okay, I am in wrong directory, I do not have permission to write here. So, I have to go into Srikanth. So, vi hello dot c, okay. So if I do cc, cc means gcc, default whatever gcc is used, hello dot c, it will create a dot out file, a dot out file. And if I run dot slash a dot out, it says hello. Okay. Now, but if I write a dot out from here, okay, already set this path home, my home is already in the system path. Let me move this a dot out to today. Okay, let me go into today. So I have a dot out here. If I type a dot out, no tab completion. If I do a dot out, it says it's not a binary, it's not in the path, whatever, no such file or directory. If I have root permission, what I can do, I can copy this a dot out to my bin folder, and if the bin, if I put this in bin folder, I can execute, then I can execute, permission denied. I have root permission to my system anyway, so I can copy. But is it a right way? Because suppose you are a Linux administrator, you have some 100 users, do you, is it safe to give root permission to all 100 users so that they can copy the raid.out files there. So what I will do is, I will set my path to this directory. What is this directory? Today. And this path is local to myself. So there is a directory known as bash rc, hidden directory, in my home folder, vi.bashrc. So you can see there are lot of customized options are available. So these are the binaries which are not available in the slash bin or slash user bin, but they are located somewhere in my home. You can see like home Srikant JDK bin. I didn't install JDK from my repositories. I didn't do apt-get install. I downloaded JDK, SunJDK. I untarred it. I installed whatever the way was, and I gave this path to my home. So whenever my system reboots, probably if I put this in some RC file, it will execute, or I have to just source this file, so it will just export this. So I'm going in much detail. I should not go like that. So let me do export. I told you about the environment variables. We started from there. Export path equals to slash, what is the present, which directory I want to make, slash home slash Srikant slash today. So my binary is in today directory, dollar path. This will, I think, append the present path to my previous path variable. So you already know what is my previous path variable. Big list. So now where I am in home. My a dot out is not here. Is it here? No. If I type a dot out, it works. Why? Because it is in my path. So this is the one example I showed. There are many environment variables which you can set by exporting it. So inside IIT you have seen a proxy. Every time you visit a site, you need a proxy authentication to give. So I gave the proxy authentication inside my bash rc. So I don't have to give proxy, export proxy every time from my command line. So this command is not persistent. If I close this terminal, this is gone. To make it persistent, what I will do, I will put this command inside my dot bash rc. That is the local dot bash rc file. So pipe will redirect your present command's output to some other output, other command. You can redirect it. Suppose where is my my ppt.tpp? Okay, so cat my ppt.tpp. So cat will print the content of my tpp file. What is tpp file? My presentation file. And it exits and it gives me a prompt back. What I want to do is, I want to pipe it. Pipe means I don't want to print it here. I want to pipe it through somewhere, and I want to search one term inside this. So what I will do, I will grep. You know already grep. So grep that pattern name. Suppose in my PPT I forgot, somewhere I have written Srikant. Is it? No, sleepy I have written somewhere. That I remember. These are small files, so I can visually verify that. But if it is a very big file and you should write inside a program, suppose your program demands that, you should find some colon dot, some pattern inside that file from some 10,000 files. Each file you have to search that pattern and you have to copy somewhere else, or you have to write another file and put those patterns in each line. Okay. So in that case, this command will help you. So what you will do, you will write instead of dot TPP, you will give us some, inside a cell script, you will write one variable for this, and that variable acts as each file in that, and it will, you will put it in a for loop. It will take all the files, search that, put it inside a another file. Compilation, how many of you compile from source in Linux? So for any compilation process, in mostly in Linux, we have three-step procedure for compilation. See, Linux is all about source, isn't it? So whenever you install a distribution, suppose I have Ubuntu desktop, When I download 700 MB of Ubuntu Desktop's ISO, what I download? Am I downloading source? We are not downloading source at all. We are downloading binaries. Source is also available. Alternatively, you can download the source also from the repositories. But most all the operating system, they ship binaries only. Why? Because user should not take pain of compiling all the source of complete operating system for his machine. If the machine architecture is known, suppose you have x64-bit computer or ARM-based computer, whatever, if your architecture is known, why you should bother? You should just download a binary which should work. I have forgot where I have CD copy back. So inside DirectFB, okay. So this is a source file I downloaded, DirectFB. DirectFB is a frame buffer component. So compiling anything from source have at least three steps in Linux environment. First step is configuring the source, is checking the dependencies of source, whether whatever packages, whatever libraries required for compiling those source package is available in that machine or not. If not, it will give some error. You have to verify that error, you have to install those libraries, those development files, etc. Then you have to make, it's a three-step process, /configure. We'll check whether, see, already this configure file is somewhere here. So what this file contain? It contains dependencies check. So it will check to install DirectFB, a frame buffer device is required. Some ls command is required, some xyz is required. It will check whether all those are installed or not. GCC is required. So /configure will execute this bash script and it's checking now. So it's checking for LD, this. If everything found, I suppose it won't fail. Of course, it didn't fail. So according to this configure file, my source, my system has sufficient libraries and packages to compile this DirectFB package source. Next is make. It will take a lot of time. I am not doing this. After make, you have to accidentally pressed. After that, you have to make install. For that, you need root permissions so as to install in system paths /bin or /user/bin like that. If not, you can stop at make and you can give the path of this directory where bashrc. You can export your path to this directory and it will, the binary will work from here itself. Okay, are we done? Yeah. File permissions. Okay, permission, we'll just see basic permissions first. So when we did ls hyphen, let me go to my favorite directory. So ls hyphen l 123.tar. So it shows me some information. So what does this first hyphen show? Is it a file or a directory? And these are arranged in triplets. So these three characters, these three characters, and these three characters. So hyphen means it's a file, of course. It has read-write permission for whom? User. And there is no execute permission for user. Read-write permission for group. What does this one mean? Shows links or number of files which is linked to, or total number of files. Not linked to anything. If I give ls hyphen l to some directory, it will show all the, it will give the number of files inside the directory if not linked somewhere else. Who is Srikanth? Is the user. And who is Srikanth here? Whenever you create a file, by default the attributes are you are the user and you are the group member. You can change this. And this is your content of, sorry, size of file, number of bytes. So when you created, when last modified, and the file name. Suppose I want to give permission of this foo.sh. So instead of foo.sh, I will use something else. So chmod is command to change the permission. You can code it like numbers also. You can give some binary numbers. you might already know, but I will do this thing. U is user, group, and others. For all, I want to give plus x, means execute permission for which file? 123.tar file. Now ls hyphen l 123.tar. How to remove the, like that, okay. Now the user is Srikanth. There are many other users in system, though I have only single user computer, only Srikanth is the only user of this computer, but many files they have some other users. Like if you are running Apache server, there will be user either Apache or www.data, okay. So if I want to change the user, sorry, yeah, user or group to Apache that Apache user, how will you change? Ch own. So there is a command in next slide. Plus will add, just have seen this. Instead of writing, oh, I was so stupid. You can easily write instead of UGO A for all file permissions. Try changing to ch own 123 dot. First, you have to give the not permitted. Why? Because I do not have, I am actually this is not my group, I am not listed in this group and I am not root as well. If I am root, I can change it. Sudo, I changed it. Now let list ls hyphen l 123.tar. You can see the group is www.data. So any other user around the world, if my laptop is connected to internet and this file is exposed and he is accessing through Apache, probably he can read the content because group has read write permission. Any other user other than Apache can't actually, I think, means there are many other ways also, but to give you a simple example, you can't read from outside. That's it.